I'd missed the first phone call, but then there was another call, but I could see on my phone that it was coming from Sweden. And so then I thought, oh no, this is either a very elaborate prank or this is serious.
I went around and roused the kids, and they were a little bit confused and didn't really know what was going on. But then we all came out and gave a lot of big hugs, and everyone was just so excited.
In a lot of cases in social sciences, we can't do experiments, kind of the way we do in medical sciences. We can't do the drug trials, but we're still very interested in causal effects. And so we want to tease those out from observational data. One example is where we looked at trying to get the effect of basic income. What we did was we surveyed people who won the lottery. Obviously, you couldn't actually do an experiment where you give some people lots of money and not to other people. But the lottery did that for us. They would get, say, 25,000 a year for 20 years. And we compare them to people who also played the lottery, but who didn't win. And we'd see how that affected their lives, how that affected their work. That would give you very credible estimates of what the cause effect of basic income is.
Guido is not just my husband, but he's also my co-author, and we've worked together on a bunch of different papers. He thinks really deeply, and he really likes to make sure he understands things. He'll keep pushing until he really understands it well enough that the math just sings to the ideas and the ideas sing to the math.
It feels great. It was just a big shock this morning, but I've just not really recovered from that since. But it's just incredible.